Good morning and welcome to our 10 o'clock service of Midweek Holy Communion here at the Holy Trinity Church, Stratford-upon-Avon. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Join together for the prayer of preparation. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbour as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Amen. Lord, have mercy. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry, and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the collect for this, the 10th week after Trinity. Let your merciful ears, O Lord, be open to the prayers of your humble servants, that they may obtain their petitions, and make them to ask such things as shall please you. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our readings are taken from the Weekday Missal, and if you have a missal at home and are following, then the page that our readings start on, page 1105. So 1105. The readings for the Wednesday. Our first reading is taken from the prophet Ezekiel, chapter 34, verses 1 to 11. The word of the Lord was addressed to me as follows: Son of man, prophesy against the shepherds of Israel. Prophesy and say to them, Shepherds, the Lord says this: Trouble for the shepherds of Israel who feed themselves. Shepherds ought to feed their flock, yet you have fed on milk. You have dressed yourselves in wool. You have sacrificed the fattest sheep, but failed to feed the flock. You have failed to make the weak sheep strong, or to care for the sick ones, or bandage the wounded ones. You have failed to bring back strays or look for the lost. On the contrary, you have ruled them cruelly and violently. For lack of a shepherd, they have scattered, to become the prey of any wild animal. They have scattered far. My flock is straying this way and that, on mountains and on high hills. My flock has been scattered all over the country. No one bothers about them, and no one looks for them. Well then, shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. As I live, I swear it, It is the Lord who speaks. Since my flock has been looted and for lack of a shepherd is now the prey of any wild animal. Since my shepherds have stopped bothering about my flock. Since my shepherds feed themselves rather than my flock. In view of all this, shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. The Lord says this, I am going to call the shepherds to account. I am going to take my flock back from them, and I shall not allow them to feed my flock. In this way, the shepherds will stop feeding themselves. I shall rescue my sheep from their mouths. They will not prey on them anymore. For the Lord says this, I am going to look after my flock myself and keep all of it in view. This is the word of the Lord. Psalm for today are words from Psalm 22, and the response after each verse, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Fresh and green are the pastures where he gives me repose. Near restful waters he leads me, to revive my drooping spirit. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me along the right path, he is true to his name. If I should walk in the valley of darkness, no evil would I fear. You are there with your crook and your staff, with these you give me comfort. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You have prepared a banquet for me in the sight of my foes. My head you have anointed with oil. My cup is overflowing. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Surely goodness and kindness shall follow me all the days of my life. In the Lord's own house shall I dwell forever and ever. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. Alleluia, alleluia. The word of God is something alive and active. It can judge secret emotions and thoughts. Alleluia. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, the kingdom of heaven is like a landowner going out at daybreak to hire workers for his vineyard. He made an agreement with the workers for 1 denarius a day, and sent them to his vineyard. Going out at about the third hour, he saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and said to them, you go to my vineyard too, and I will give you a fair wage. So they went. At about the sixth hour, and again at about the ninth hour, he went out and did the same. Then at about the 11th hour, he went out and found more men standing around, and he said to them, why have you been standing here idle all day? Because no one has hired us, they answered. Then he said to them, you go into my vineyard too. In the evening, the owner of the vineyard said to his bailiff, call the workers and pay them their wages, starting with the last arrivals and ending with the first. So those who were hired at about the 11th hour came forward and received 1 denarius each. When the first came, they expected to get more. But they too received 1 denarius each. They took it, but grumbled at the landowner. The men who came last, they said, have done only 1 hour, and you have treated them the same as us, though we have done a heavy day's work in all the heat. He answered one of them and said, my friend, I am not being unjust to you. Did we not agree on 1 denarius? Take your earnings and go. I have chosen to pay the last comer as much as I pay you. I have no right to do what I have I no right to do what I like with my own money. Why be envious because I am generous? Thus the first will be last, and the last will be first. This is the gospel of the Lord. Sometimes in Jesus' parables, we have people behaving in ways that others would find surprising or even foolish. and the behaviour of the father in the parable of the prodigal son, for example. He gives an extraordinary welcome to a son who had done something nothing to deserve it. And the reaction of his older brother in the story is in keeping with how many people would have reacted if it happened in real life. And today's parable of the workers in the vineyard is a little bit like that parable. The behaviour of the owner of the vineyard would have been considered very strange and even foolish in Jesus' time. He gave the same day's wages to workers who only worked for 1 hour. Many people tend to react to the parable somewhat negatively, even today. Just as we often feel sorry for the elder son in the parable of the prodigal son, we tend to feel sorry for the workers who worked all day, and yet not the same as those who worked only for an hour. Yet the workers who worked all day got a day's wages for their work, which is what the vineyard owner had promised them. And what is strange and unsettling is that those who worked for only an hour also got the same rate of pay. Jesus began this parable with the words, "The kingdom of heaven is like." The parable is saying something about how God relates to us. Jesus is saying that God is extraordinarily generous, that there is nothing calculating about how God relates to us. God's giving is not dependent on our doing, and thank God for that. For all of us, there will come a time in our lives when, for one reason or another, we can't do a great deal. And Jesus seems to be saying that this has no impact on how God relates to us. God does not ask us to be deserving, but only to be receptive and to share what we receive from him with one another. Amen. So with Christians around the world, we affirm our faith through the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. So in the power of the Spirit and in union with we bring our prayers before God, our loving Father. God loves the world that he has made, and so we pray for ourselves and for all people. As you have given power to your people and the gift of faith, make that faith powerful as a witness to your love. And we pray for your church around the world, especially mindful of those areas where there is genuine persecution for the practice of the Christian faith. We pray within our own diocese for our bishops, Christopher and John, for all priests and lay people who serve under their authority. And we are mindful of our ministry as a church here in this place. Let your church be constant in prayer, never doubting your power to save. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gather into your fold the lost sheep of this world, those who struggle to believe, those who have become hard-hearted. Hear those who desire to know you but cannot speak their need. And guide and guard our families and all others with whom we share our lives, especially in these difficult times. We pray for those whom we know personally to be affected through loss of jobs, for those anxious about the future. Bless their homes where there is anxiety and worry. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Bring healing to those whom we know to be in sickness, need, or any other adversity. Those who are ill or in pain. Those who are caring for others in need. Especially in our prayers, we remember Cliff Perry, Greta Shorey, Ken Room, David Renfrew, Dick Brooks, Edith Brooks, Gabrielle Edwards. Give peace to all unquiet minds and troubled spirits, and bring comfort and healing to those in any kind of need. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. And give peace to the dead who have had no peace in their dying. Especially we remember those recently departed of this life, those known to our parish and those known personally in our own lives. Our prayers especially for Jeffrey Lees, Elaine Loomis, Thomas Ford and Joan Rogers. Have compassion on those who died without faith, that they too may receive your mercy. And fed at the table of the Lord, we ask him to accept our faith and pardon our unworthiness. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. So we come to share the peace. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. The peace of the Lord be always with you. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Father, we give you thanks and praise for your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh as your Son born of the Blessed Virgin. He lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption as we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. We bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. So let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though there are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Let us pray. God of our pilgrimage, you have willed that the gate of mercy should stand open for those who trust in you. Look upon us with your favour, that we who follow the path of your will may never wander from the way of life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so I thank you for joining with me for this midweek communion, and we will have a service being broadcast from the diocese 10 o'clock on Sunday morning, and then at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, for those who have booked, there will be an Eucharist here at Holy Trinity Church. May God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.